Hey guys, you broke your prayers and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Westerlo career mode, where last time I left off, I picked up two more wins in the playoffs, continuing my good run. And I'm kind of confused as to
Gonna have a fine game for you. Welcome to it. Martin Tyler here, along with Alan Smith. The game for you today is Westerlo against Genk.
Well, given how late we are in the season,
what's happened overall?
The title decided this one between first and second.
So far, and I don't know.
Contest, they've given us so much so far.
Mathematically, I've won, but. It didn't tell me I'd won.
I think that back four is really important for them.
Let me explain. Currently, I am top of the playoffs mini league.
In front of them, they got players who are going to be working really hard.
Undefeated in four games, I have 12 points.
The shot gets blocked
from those four games. If you want to look at it like that. That puts
the home team with all the cards here, it seems, especially the points that they got for winning the away game on the ground of the opposition here.
Points.
Well, if they
picked out a man with the cross, now a chance.
Compared to the team in second place, who have 34 points.
A goal kick. And in the news, because speculation about him finishing his career.
Now, you can do the math for yourself.
He might be feeling his body.
And when I say this is my fifth game of 10, then you can probably see why I'm confused. I was thinking maybe the points are there from, like, it kind of like halved the points of everyone from what they finished up with in the league. But the way, since it didn't give me the, it didn't award me with, you know, the, it didn't say I had won. I'm guessing they're there, but it's gonna be like they aren't, you know? So, it'll be like we're starting a new 10. Team mini league.
They've got the formula. Goalkeeper was reaching for it, and it did actually touch him on the way in.
I think there was just too much power on the ball.
And I will have to win that to win the league itself as a whole. That's the only thing I could come up with.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
Wait. That makes no fucking sense, but that's the only thing I could come up with. If that is the case, then this will put me on 15 points for 15. And the team, like, the next team in terms of points from the games they've played already, so far it is actually Genk who I'm playing here. Because from their first four games, they have 5 points. For the possibility that, you know, they may be just overtaken
from the last 5 games,
depending on results elsewhere.
And shoots! Great save by a diving goalkeeper.
Now,
well, there, a goal
if
up.
That is the case, then I'll win the mini league, if that's what you want to call it. Anyway, in the next couple of games, maybe even in this episode, if results go my way. So,
I did fancy him in that position, I've got to say, having taken his earlier goal.
That's really the only thing I could think of. Maybe I'm looking at it wrong. I don't know. I really don't know. I don't know why they even bothered
came in with a challenge
keeping giving us
could be dangerous.
The points, half our points from the season. May as well start a zero if the points from the other games don't matter. Because if they do, then I've already won.
Real chance. He's kept it out.
The playoffs and have already won the league.
Push their lead now to two ahead. They played well to
so,
this point.
You know.
But sometimes a two-goal lead can be a dangerous one. We'll see. Goalkeeper almost got there, but it wasn't a strong enough touch.
Yeah, he's annoyed with himself, isn't he? Having got a touch on it, feels he should have done better.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0. Got the tackle in. Poole.
And that this is going much better than
in good position
game.
Here.
Did the game in the last episode of the second here. Team and had to play due to fitness issues. 2-0, pull up before half time.
Score a goal at any point in a game. He hasn't really looked
in
like
the,
so far, has he?
Last episode, I need a 90th minute penalty to win in the game in my play with the second team.
You know, he doesn't need too many touches to make a difference.
So it's good to know.
That's what's going to be played for added time.
Maybe they've learned from that game, and it's why they are giving me a much better performance in this game.
2-0. Not often, Alan, do you see one man have one half like he's had.
On top of his game out there, and I'm sure he'll be thinking about grabbing his hat-trick in the second half.
Second half started here by Westerlo. Good forward play.
Romance. He can like... Oh, a good save.
Well, that's gone behind. It'll be a corner.
Palmed away by the keeper.
And he heads it.
Cool.
And the goalkeeper has done
no.
well to stop that one.
The header wasn't good enough to get past the Genk goalkeeper.
And this is going to be a throw. Good position. They've worked this attack very well into a quite
clean through. 3-0. Oh,
three of the best.
Well, the man just loves to score when he gets in the mood. Nico. Hey, scoring another hat trick.
Well,
dude loves to score hat tricks.
Get three goals in a team like this, against opposition like this. It's a special day.
Certainly is. For a special player, too. A player that. He's the clinical sort, and he's shown us that today.
That's given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway. Comes in with a tackle. Manager thinking for the away side, time for a change.
Romance.
Onto the attack now. Well, that's a clever pass.
Nikolic. Yes! It's going to go in, it's 4. Hernil. Oh, just on the hour mark.
One, two touch stuff.
Perfect.
Between this team. Well, the opposition couldn't get near.
just what you would want from
came close to goalkeeper.
Second
actually did get a touch
perform
on it,
just as well as the main team.
Do that much. Well beaten, really.
The keeper got a bit of the ball, but he didn't block it enough because it still had the momentum to go over the line. I don't know what number 6 was doing. He was nowhere near clearing it away.
It's been an hour of very good football here. We've still got 30 more minutes.
Fail.
I'm sure we're going to enjoy that as well. You can see what he was trying to do. Just stretch the opposition by getting the ball out wide, but it's gone out for a throw. The lack of performance today. I think those who are saying that maybe he's had his time, had his career, they might be agreeing with that. And he looked pretty disappointed himself.
Yeah, he did. If he's thinking of retiring, that kind of performance will probably seal his decision.
And it will be their throw.
Everything is going absolutely fantastic.
Part of the pitch.
Ooh.
He's got it away.
Almost got it into the feet of Nikolic for another goal. Hey man. Yes.
It could have got through there, but the defender was absolutely on top of his game.
Oxford.
He's coming forward with some danger.
Oxford.
That's a good block.
Otto and Kawata are going to bring it back.
The goal, but they still got the ball.
Swings into the box. Reece Oxford header is over the bar.
Not quite the success rate that he's had recently.
Yeah, he
should have been another goal.
Missing that, and you can see why.
The young.
Time ticking on. Just over 15 minutes
defender
to go.
Slash central midfielder.
And that will be a
just
throw.
Couldn't put his header on target. And make 5 mil.
Attacking well
with
here.
Romans.
I see a substitute coming on for the away team here.
Keeps the ball in play. Nikolic. Mias again! Blocked, it's going to be a corner.
The ball's just deflected behind for that. I think we've got to pay credit to the fullback who's been marking the winger because he's given him nothing, Alan, has he? And so, and it's a headed effort.
Kawata! Bad header. It'll be a Genk goal kick.
Got the away manager indicating he wants to make a substitution now. There's good progress with this attack.
Nikolic.
And in he goes with the tackle. 4 minutes of added time to come.
It's out for a throw. It's,
into the attacking third.
Closing on the end of the match.
And it will go into the middle now. He's given the free kick. It's in a really threatening position too.
I think the free kick was given.
These days, going off your feet like that is running the risk of the referee taking serious action.
He caught my player all right, but it was mostly after the ball was already crossed. The referee felt the need to put it back anyway. Not that it matters. 4-0 the final score. 3 more points. Points on the board.
They never let up, did they? They kept
5 wins from 5.
A very big margin of
3. Yeah. And perfect. What more does need be said? there you can see how the table with the points that's giving it looks. I mean, do your own. Mass. Bruges are the only ones anywhere near me. In terms of, even if we were just looking at this from the games we've played standpoint, they would only have 10 points. I have 15. That's a huge gap. Genk's defeat to me keeps them on 5 points. Everyone else has 4. If we were going by how many points they would have if we'd started from 0, which, I mean, if you're gonna have these, and if they are like a mini league, and like, if that's how it is, then you may as well start every team from 0 who make it into the playoffs. What is the point of having those points? You may as well have me on 15, and Genk on 10, and etc. Understand it. I want to understand it, but it's like trying to understand a foreign language. I may as well be looking at German or Chinese or something like that. I don't understand it. I really don't. Someone really needs to help me out here. A win here, since some play looks like me versus Anderlecht is the first of the sixth set of games.
Defense, the best defense in the division, against a side that just can't find the back of the opponent's net. The lowest.
This will a win here will put
in this company. They'll find it hard
on
to get goals,
18 points, which would as
this one.
Those visiting strikers really have been short on confidence, but you know, a little chance.
You got 8 points.
Change.
Now you've got your chance to check on the lineup for the home team.
The Club Brugge really will need to trim down before.
Solid. But they've got a bit of protection, haven't they?
By the time they play.
They should have more than enough. I mean, they're all good defenders in their own rights, but in front of them, they've got players who are going to be working really hard. Whether they could be a.
I guess we'll find out for sure. In the next episode, the episode that will go up on
the kind of players that we expect,
Thursday,
the kind of performances we expect from the in.
And heads it towards.
Indeed.
Well, they've broken through here with a really good goal. And the celebration
is like a mini league.
The support
and,
crazy.
It's a historic goal from Gamboa. Huh. Now, you guys already. No,
we'll
he already
look at this,
is
Smith.
Well and truly smashed
this one.
Well, he timed
the top goal score,
timed the header,
a record for the Pro League. But that is his 50th league goal, which means he is in the record book. He has done something that Cristiano Ronaldo and Sadio Mane couldn't do, reaching 50 goals in a single league season.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
Now, you could say, hey, with 10 extra games on top of the 30 he already had.
And it's gone out for a throw. No wasting of time
maybe it was a
in
bit
that situation
for him. But
well, good through ball. And the cross coming in. And it's a heading chance now. That is his stocking.
I'll say what I said when someone asked me on Twitter.
Yeah, there was enough of the goal to aim at there. Gotta go down as a...
No, that's not the case at all. Because 30 plus 10. That's 40. The Premier League is where Ronaldo and Mane both got 30 plus goals in the Premier League for me.
The reverse match,
in Liverpool career mode in two separate FIFAs.
A fair way away from home.
The Premier League every season has 38 games for each team. That's only two games less. So, no, really, Gamboa only played two extra games. But yet, he has reached 50. And those two players, one who is considered to be one of the best in the world, and Sadio Mane, who is no slouch when he's in form.
There's going to be a throw in after that tackle.
You're telling me that those
guys
are struggling?
All the way there, literally to the opposition.
Compared to Gamboa, I think Gamboa is just showing the quality that he is
throw in now.
Definitely capable of. I mean, well, a lot of props should go to the to his teammates because no. Oh man, there is no I in team for sure.
And this is going to be a throw.
The Gamboa is definitely like a one-man team.
Crosses in. He worked hard to get the cross in, but it didn't reach any of his teammates arriving in the middle. And here's the shot. He's reached it and turned it aside. Well, they might not.
I think teams would be happy to score 50 goals a season.
In a season.
Depending on how many they concede.
I got 50 goals with one freaking player.
And he heads.
There's another player who.
Good jump.
Who
keep it down.
Is two you know, goals away from joining the Ford club.
I've been, Alpo.
Or Strandberg. Or whatever name you want.
It's gone out for a
media use firm. He's also. Oh. Lurking.
Into the attacking third. Just working away to try and find an opening. Real opening now. He's kept it out. Oh, off the crossbar and behind for a goal kick. Obradovic. Trying to get it wide, and it was a good idea, but he couldn't find his supporting player.
I don't know why I did that. That was a bad throw.
And in he goes with the tackle. And they're passing so well out there. Good interception. Could be dangerous. That's great defending there, stopping that attack. Patience is the name of the game at the moment.
Don't concede a sloppy goal before half time.
And he's got the ball away from him with the tackle. Shots on here. Well, you've got
to wire and mark it to goal kick, and that will be the end of the half.
And he's used his head there to.
There is Alpo. Maybe there is more to this. Ah! Oh!
Goalkeeper made the save, but he couldn't hold it. And that's half time.
End to end stuff right there.
The half time score. It's still tight, but when you struggle to score goals, it's an awkward position to be in at half-time, and they are trailing.
Well, being such low scorers, it does put an awful lot of pressure on the defenders.
The kind of players that we expect, the kind of performances we expect from... And heads it towards goal!
Stanley Asian, War Gym are also on apparently, even though I checked and it said they weren't.
Obradovic. Good position, they've worked this attack very well.
That means Bruges and Genk are playing each other.
Player's done well here until it was the direction of the pass, really. Right
is,
idea, but
handy.
This man is out over the touchline.
Can take points off each other.
Christensen.
Oh, great play, Alcosta.
And here comes the counter attack.
Throw on goal! Oh, what another fantastic save. That's on par with the one he made at the end of the first half.
Good challenge here. Looking to play his teammate through.
Acosta. Ah,
over the bar.
But not quite what he was hoping for.
But when he's hit it, I'm sure he would have thought that was going to bulge in the back of the net. Not quite, though.
It's a tactical substitution for the losing team here.
And Elector making a change.
Tried to tackle here, and he's done that. Good forward play. Voila.
Goes for a goal over the bar.
Clear.
Well, it looked like the perfect counter-attack. The whole defence had been beaten, but the keeper wasn't.
Another turnover in play here with that interception. Appia. And the away team want to make a change. And that's a turnover to the opposition. Excellent interception. Moving forward with some danger to the opposition now they're here. We know how many late goals come in this competition. They want another
way. Forced the rush cross from Hanny.
Waving quite a few defenders forward. Just going to get that ball into the box, whichever way is possible.
Which gives me the goal kick. Come on, win that. Oh, lackadaisical pass from Mantelec.
Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation.
Across the block, Denver 2-0. And that might be all 3 points signed, sealed, and delivered.
Well, he's doubled up here with his second goal, and he took it in excellent style, just like the first one.
So put me on 18 points. Three games remaining. No, wait. Four. Sorry, four.
This is the starting at 2-0.
Just over. I'm getting so confused.
On my watch.
Who's?
Obradovic. That will help ease the pressure.
This will put me 8 points clear.
He's coming.
We get down to the
danger.
Business end.
To it first. That's clear.
Playoffs.
Play. It'll be a corner. Excellent.
And
the
Pro League in general.
It's pretty much done, and they're just loving it. I don't think we'll get them out of the ground. And he goes for goal with his head.
Oh.
It will be their throw. Seven more minutes to go. It's the keeper.
I dropped it nicely into the box, but no one picked it up. This game is gonna be over soon. Along this.
And the game drawing to a close.
Oh, come on! That's a very soft foul that the referee just gave against me there.
Well, this attack has got a bit of menace to it. Well, they've been thwarted here. That's a sign of better things to come. And here's the
no! Are you kidding me?
It's brought the match back into sharper.
I mean, it's consolation goal. They're not getting an equalizer.
He's down to one. And there's still opportunities for them.
I should have lashed that
into the scoreline.
Rebounded, then it would have gone out for a goal kick.
They've got to find another goal in the seconds that remain.
It's lifted the team and it's lifted the crowd. You just never know how the team that's just conceded are going to react now.
I'm really pissed off about that. 2-1. Shouldn't have ended 2-1. I mean, it's my own fault, but I'm really pissed off about it. I'm gonna end this video here, and I just need to take a moment to calm down before I record the next episode. Until the next episode, thanks for watching. I'll enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.